Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for some more solo queue silliness here on the channel. Thank you everybody who's been watching and liking the series here today. As you could probably tell from the thumbnail and or possibly the title, I'm sure I've come up with something that's not so witty, but I'm going to pretend it is anyway. I'm going to be playing as Rhaegar, someone who I've never actually played before, again following on the heels of what was quite possibly one of the most hilariously awful games in the series thus far. From the previous Murky game, so that was interesting indeed. Thank you everyone who's also been offering tips and advice for Murky. I did find out later on that I was indeed not using the egg correctly, and supposedly Murky is supposed to die over and over again, so go figure on that. Let's see, Spiritwalker's Grace, reduce mana costs, and Lightning Shield, increases basic attack damage. Let's go for that, so let me take a look at Rhaegar's abilities really fast here. Before we get started, his Q is Chain Heal. I think that one is pretty much, there's no explanation needed because I did play a Shaman briefly in World of Warcraft. Lightning Shield. Imbue an ally with Lightning Shield. Deals damage, Earthbind. Basically slows him, that's about it. So it does look like we are going up against Arthas. And then his Ghost Wolf has a combat trait. And I am going to go ahead and Chain Heal.
Now that's a healer I can get behind.
I like that. I'm going to go ahead and Lightning Shield on Falstad. So on our team today, it's going to be Rhaegar, Falstad, Zagara, Tyrael, and ETC. And we're taking on Arthas, Zagara, Jimmy Raynor, Tychus, and who else are we playing? Zagara. Wait, no, I already said Zagara. Who did I miss? Oh, we're playing against another Rhaegar. Okay. So Zagara doing her thing. So many Baneling damage. So I definitely already like the fact that Rhaegar has a heal. He has it's a utility. It possibly is supposed to be a melee support hero, which is very awesome indeed. As everyone hopefully knows by now, I do enjoy playing support. And which is why I had such high hopes for Murky. And a lot of people were saying that I need to give Murky another try. I probably will. I probably shouldn't have healed him there because he's going back, but that's all right. I will admit that I probably said you know, I'm not going to be killing Murky ever again a little bit too soon, without really knowing the character, and I take full responsibility for that. But at the same time, there's certain types of heroes and roles that I enjoy playing, and certain types that I do not enjoy. And that was, I mean, Murky just was not a champion I was enjoying at the start anyway. But like I said, I will give Murky a second chance. And I definitely take responsibility for not only for not understanding the hero as much as I probably should have, but also not taking the time to read the abilities. I will admit that. But hey, that's why we call it solo queue silliness, because I play champions I usually never would. Some people are also asking me what champion do I usually play, and that is going to be Illidan. I usually main, if I do have a main character is in Heroes of the Storm, it is going to be Illidan. Here comes Tyrael helping us from mid. I definitely need to be careful. Gather tribute. I think now is probably a good time for me to go back. Let's see, periodic key, increase the chain heal. Chain heals on allies with Lightning Shield active or increased. Yeah, that sounds good. Sounds good. I am a wolf. So it looks like the enemy team is probably going to get the first tribute. And I will have to say that Curse of the Raven Lord is by far my least favorite mount. Trying to catch up as fast as I can. Here comes Falstad leaping on in. Baneling do so much damage. Are they able to take down Arthas? Tychus and Rhaegar finding themselves like, caught in a rock in a hard place here. So even though they got the first, tribute, they are not able to really capitalize on that. ETC coming in again. Whoa!
Choose a talent.
Chain heal was on cooldown. I couldn't heal him in time. So what is the Earthbind? Yeah, all it does is slow. Okay, so it does exactly what it does and what you would think it does, which is... I wanted to make sure I wasn't using it incorrectly. But it has like a pathetically low radius, it looks like. Understood. So I am going to be using that empowered ability that I have. Not empowered, I'm sorry, the chain healing that gets more power based on whether or not my target has lightning shield. Let's go. But the Zagara is definitely not a good matchup for anyone playing melee. Let's see. Lightning shield also gives a shield. Okay. Yo, dog, I heard you like shields. So we put a shield on your lightning shield so you can still be shielded while you shield. I'm going to shield myself again. It's like a double shield, only better. I don't know where Falstad went, but I am not going to be able to hold on to bottom much longer. Looks like they're up taking out the tribute up there. And again, there's not really much I can do here against Zagara. Zagara is a really bad matchup for anyone melee. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to go back and heal. Should be able to get back down there in time to get save the fort. We did get that tribute. So that's where Rhaegar, or that's where Falstad was. Those mercs are doing a lot of damage to our fort that needs to be stopped.
If you wish my blessing, you better run.
And there is the tribute. Let's go. However, right now, I'm going to need to clear up this bottom lane. Alright. Cleared bottom. Let's see what you've got. Choose. Looks like we were able to get the tribute uncontested. Bloodlust. Give allied heroes movement speed and attack speed. Which is exactly what Bloodlust does. Yeah, so far I really like Rhaegar, other than the fact that it does seem like for a support for a melee support hero, he doesn't really have a whole lot of damage, which I wouldn't expect him to have like a ton of damage. But at the same time, I think a little bit more utility as far as possibly gap closers, maybe something like that. But overall, I mean, I can definitely see myself playing as Rhaegar. Rhaegar is very, very cool indeed. I'm guessing I can't heal the Grave Golem. Me and the Grave Golem doing Boku damage on this. I wonder if Bloodlust will actually work with the Grave Golem. I think I owe it to everyone to test this. It does not. Alright. I'm just going to let the Grave Golem take all the damage from the mainlings. Of course, the forts are not going to be firing right now because we have Curse of the Raven Horde up. Should theoretically be able to take this down before the curse is up. There we go. Just able to get it. I'm fine with that. Grave Golem did his duty. I did my duty, and I am headed back home. Spell Shield. Spell Shield or Healing Surge. Let's go for Healing Surge. I like to heal people. So it looks like we're gonna have a base erasing. Gonna go help our Zagara player up top. Now Zagara and Rhaegar in the same lane, that is something that's terrifying. That would be a quite terrifying lane, I would say so myself. So I'm gonna grab this watchtower.
Enough. I shall do no more without suitable tribute.
So we pushed fairly well on that. I smell them. And I'm gonna continue to push top lane now. It does seem like, I wonder, let's see, 30 speed, deal 100%. Basic attacks in wolf form deal 100% more damage, but cancel work in wolf form. So how does that work? So I'm supposed to, it looks like maybe I'm supposed to toggle wolf form if I want to get extra damage. That's a little bit weird. 308, yeah, it does. It does 100% more damage, that's for sure, but it also cancels multiple. Kind of messed that up there, so I should have put Swarm Shield on. Or Lightning Shield first, that's alright. Okay, so yeah, so there is a little bit of a stance-dance mechanic here with Rhaegar, it looks like. If I just want to absolutely get a ton of damage, I want to put the Lightning Shield on. And then swap to Ghost Wolf form. If I want to get just an extra attack, which will immediately shapeshift me out, but I at least get that one empowered attack. And it does look like Ghost Form does not require any... Ghost Form does not require any mana, and it has no cooldown, so... That's good to know. Let's see if we can take out Zagara up here. I also do have Bloodlust. Keep that in mind.
Let's go.
So I should be able to turn this around here. We are fighting a 1v2 now. Or, sorry, a 2v4 now. Run, Volstead. Ghost form is indeed instant, so. Lightning Shield saves my life. Let's see. Also gives you a Lightning Shield if used on allies. Gains root and increased cast range. I like that. I do like that. If the Earthbind Totem can gain a root, that is amazing. Now goes Zagara. Lycus doing tons of damage. It's only going to be Tyrael on the tank, so I need to come up here and hopefully be able to save Tyrael possibly. I was able to save Tyrael for now.
Fortune to the just.
Oh, that root though.
Well fought.
So I was able to save Tyrael and grab a couple kills. Which is super good. Definitely take it. Oh man, that does so much damage. Yeah, Rhaegar definitely has got it going on, I gotta say. And the Bloodlust too, oh man. Arthas can't get away from the Bloodlust. That was our Falstad though, by the way. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to save Falstad, but we did push Arthas all the way back. Oh, maybe I will be able to save Falstad. Well, I have no mana. That's a problem. Nope, wasn't able to save. I tried. I definitely tried. We're not gonna be able to get this tribute here. Material using Judgment on I think that was Brainer.
Look, Rhaegar.
But yeah, I definitely like Rhaegar, man. Rhaegar is super good. The fact that the stance dancing mechanic is in is very, very neat indeed. I have to go save Tyrael again, it looks like.
Double.
Oh, maybe not.
I suggest we capture this mercenary camp.
And are they going for it? Looks like they're actually going for the mercenary camp. And did they get it? Not yet. So the other Rhaegar did use Bloodlust there. And let's see if we can turn this one around. Nope. There's the laser. Oh, I didn't get off that route in time. Oh, gotta be careful on that one. Run, Tyrael! Got no more mana. Don't think I'm gonna be able to save Tyrael there. Rhaegar is definitely mana hungry. Top lane got pushed all the way to our fourth, so right now, I mean, it's been a pretty close game. I thought that we were ahead more than we were, especially considering that we got the first curse, but apparently not. And I'm gonna have to go up to a top lane to deal with this now. My curse upon you. We're gonna have to weather the storm here during this curse. And it's only going to get tougher as the enemy team is going around getting jungle camps. And I feel that I probably need to be doing this up here in top lane because I don't think anyone else is. Big crit there by Rhaegar. And if I could push this top lane back all the way, that would be very, very helpful. As top has been the weakest lane so far, but now they have a Grave Golem. So I'm gonna have to go back here and help them in bot lane. The enemy team did not do as much damage as they potentially could have right there. That definitely could have been a lot worse. And again, with me pushing top lane, that certainly did help things. Alright, basic attacks chained to enemy, activate to grant shields nearby allies. Yeah, let's go for shield. I need to be placed for it. So what the enemy team is doing right now is that they just went back and they backtracked to grab the mercs, which is probably not the right idea, although their entire team is. Oh, could get in there in time. See if I can catch up. I should be able to catch up to Jimmy here. There we go. That's what we needed. Tribute spawned right here. Very good. The enemy team lost a lot of resources there. Big turnaround for us. Arthas is pushing top lane, so I'm going to go back and then head towards top. I don't think Arthas can. Even though Arthas was doing a lot of damage to Murky in that Murky game. I don't think that he can deal. Oh, there's Arthas right there. Well, never mind. I think that Rhaegar definitely poses a much bigger threat than. I don't know why they're diving so hard there in mid. But yeah, I'm gonna go back. I did see Zagara. Looking like Zagara wanted to come up here. And I will say bring it on. Gather tribute. There we go. So I will have Bloodlust for this fight. I'm gonna see if I can save Tyrael. Not gonna happen. Crit on the enemy Rhaegar was huge. We're not gonna be able to get the tribute, but that was pretty big. Rhaegar thought he had it on me, but turns out he did not. But unfortunately, we're not gonna be able to get that last tribute. But I don't think we're going to need the tribute to get the win. We just need to not. I don't know why Falstad and whoever else was in mid. I don't know why they were dying. I think it was ETC. I don't know why they went so hard in mid. But split pushing this right now, I think, is to our benefit. Especially with two of us down, we can at least get the lanes pushed back. And by the time the other two teammates respawn, I think we should be good to go. And oh man, that's a big crit. So there they all are in mid. I think it's actually going to be better if I just go back now.
I hope you can hurry.
So there's the final tribute. We have this Grave Golem that we need to take out. Enemy team is going to be able to take out. They're going to be able to get the next tribute, which is unfortunate. Right now, the enemy team is beating us on objectives, and again, it's a super duper close game. There's bottom that I pushed all the way back there. We're gonna have mercs coming our way on the bot lane, which I'm gonna have to go deal with. I don't think my totem is going to root the Grave Golem yet. Although I did get rooted by something, I think I was by the Grave Golem. Team is going to get the final tribute here, and that's probably going to be game because we are not going to be able to stop this next push. And unfortunately, our team died too much there in that last engagement, which is unfortunate. But it wouldn't be solo queue silliness without silliness going on. I also forgot that I had a shield, a spell shield. I don't know why we were overextending like that. I would like an explanation of that one. That would be Zagara. That would be Zagara and Tyrael's fault. I don't know why they thought it would be a good idea to fight that while they were taking out that camp. Very, very bad call by Tyrael. I mean, the team wasn't there. Just because you say get there now and you happen to be the only one in position does not mean that we can all be there at once, Tyrael. So, yeah. So that will be it. I do like Rhaegar a lot. I think on a better team, he's definitely going to be a lot more helpful than other characters. And I hope to see you next time here on the channel. So long, everybody.